I mean, we can't talk straight in the barbershop, then where can we talk straight? We can't talk straight nowhere else. You know, this ain't nothing but healthy conversation.
Art 101 with Mr. Burger.
Welcome back to this episode of Art 101. First off, I'm Mr. Burger, and I try to bring you the best in art history videos. These are intended for individuals 13 years of age and older, and as always, I appreciate likes, shares, and new subscribers.
Yeah, that's right. It took me a long time, but I'm finally there.
As you know, February is Black History Month, and I really wanted to make a video on one of my favorite artists, Jacob Lawrence. I've been fighting a cold and just under the weather, so it's been a struggle to get it done, but the show must go on.
Oh, Hercules, Hercules, Hercules,
what's
Hercules!
Now, one of the all-time best in the area of art, one of my all-time favorites, is a gentleman by the name of Jacob Lawrence. And he is very much affiliated with a group in Harlem called the Harlem Renaissance. So today, let's jump into his story so you get a little bit better appreciation for Jacob Lawrence and the artists of the Harlem Renaissance.
It's getting very, very interesting here.
One of the most important artists of contemporary art is Jacob Lawrence. He's best known for his narrative paintings that show aspects of African-American history and everyday life. Mr. Lawrence was born in Atlantic City, New Jersey in 1917. When he was really little, his parents split up and he moved all around the place with his single mom and his brother and sister. Because of hardships, the kids were eventually placed into foster care for a very short time. The family would reunite when they would move from Philadelphia to Harlem, New York.
When we moved to Harlem from Philadelphia, I was 13 years of age. So I had nothing to, everything was new to me. You see, I didn't select to do that. So, and I liked to paint. I think what played a part too was the Great Depression, in that because of that, as we know, the Roosevelt administration at that time set up all these centers throughout the country. To give people work, and if you didn't have money, which I didn't have, and many of my peers didn't have, or our parents didn't have, and if you like music, you can go into these centers and get free instruction, free guidance. If it was dance, you do the same thing, or art, you do the same thing. So at the time, it was a paradox of those in my age group really benefited from the Depression.
Although the 1920s Harlem Renaissance was just before Lawrence's time, his style was greatly based upon the Harlem Renaissance.
You better think about what you're saying. You better think about the consequences of your actions.
I started going there after school at the expense of my own school work. I was anxious to get there. And then I came in contact with many other people who were probably thinking the same way I was thinking, or having the same kind of experience. And we came in contact with older people. And when I say older, you know, when you're 15, a person 25, they're ready to leave the world. That's what you think of it. So we all had this kind of a wonderful experience. And not, it's only in retrospect that you realize how much this meant to our lives and to our development.
He ain't lying.
Now what do I know? I color for a living, but I even know that the Harlem Renaissance was very influential, not only to African-American arts, but American arts.
I want you to look and I want you to listen.
So what is the Harlem Renaissance?
So let's define that.
Renaissance literally means rebirth, and this is a rebirth of black culture in Harlem during the 1920s.
You hear me clear enough?
Jazz, vaudeville, literature, philosophy, and a very distinct visual art style.
I've got to get myself ready.
There were many great artists that came out of the Harlem Renaissance. Some of those include Aaron Douglas, Augusta Savage, James Vanderzee, William Johnson, Palmer Hayden, Henry O. Tanner, Charles White, Norman Lewis, and Selma Burke.
My partner! I can't believe this shit!
As a teen, his mom would enroll him in art classes at an art center as an after-school program. As time passed, he was soon awarded a scholarship to the American Art School. But this was a hard-felt time for our country, and during the Great Depression, he worked for the WPA Easel Division. And it would be around this time that he would create his first series, 41 paintings based on the life of Toussaint Louverture, a man that went from slavery to the leader of the revolution in Haiti.
That was pretty.
He would create other historical series based on people including Harriet Tubman, Frederick Douglass, and John Brown.
I think the sources of my content in selecting Harriet Tubman, Frederick Douglass, and Toussaint Louverture was more of a self-expression and maybe seeing myself in these roles. My parents were separated. So the last I saw my father, until years later, I must have been about 5 or 6 years of age. So therefore, I didn't have a complete family unit. So maybe this was a motivating factor in having this kind of a relating to this kind of heroes or heroines, or maybe it was myself I was putting down on paper. So I can only think in those terms now. But maybe that's what it was. Maybe. Again, I think of what else would I be doing? Would my life have been a destructive one had I not had this outlet?
He also made a series based on the African-American migration from the South to the North following the Civil War.
Oh, this is the biggest one I ever had. You hear that, Elizabeth? I'm coming to join you, honey.
And like that migration series, Lawrence's paintings went well beyond the historical figures alone. The intention of his work was to help people see the history from an African-American perspective that was often overlooked by history. As his artwork was examined then or now, he gave a history, a view, a biography, and a story of an overlooked group of people in our American history.
Some have said my art is social commentary or it's protest. It couldn't be anything else if I grew up in the Harlem community, and that was the source of my content, if you want to interpret it that way.
I never knew art could be such a cool deal, and I'm not kidding myself about painting. I know how I rate. Head and shoulders under the other dudes.
Beyond just showing history, he also helped form it, like his artwork from the Munich, Germany Olympic Games.
There's an old saying. Yeah. There's an old saying that those that can do and those that can't teach. That is definitely not the case with Jacob Lawrence.
I enjoy teaching. I found it very stimulating and rewarding. I've gotten so much out of it. I've been retired now since 1983, but I do miss the students, and having worked with them so many years.
You have to think, young brother.
Many of his students were inspired by his work and infused these historical ideas into their works as well. He began his teaching career in the summers in Maine in 1954. He would go on to teach at the Pratt Institute in Brooklyn, New York in 1955 and the University of Washington in Seattle in 1970, where he would remain until his retirement in 1983.
I know what you're going to say. You don't have to say it.
I think the value of being involved in the arts in general, that it adds to a quality of life that anyone on any level can appreciate. And it opens up an entire dimension that I dread to think if we didn't have this, if we didn't have this experience, what would happen? What would we not have?
Yeah.
Now that is a great story.
Hey, come back.
All right.